G'day, this is Alister Christie from LearnDelphi.tv, and in this video we are going to take a look at variable height list view items in FireMonkey. So there is a sample project. If we have a look in Object Pascal, multi-device samples, user interface, list view, and variable height items. So let's open that project. And we'll just check that's on Windows, so that's nice and quick to compile and debug, and we'll run it and we'll have a quick look at what it does. So if we go fill list, we can add a number of items, and it's basically some text with variable height and variable length, I guess, as well. And we can see that it's using different fonts and text to, you know, make the list item height vary. And we've got a number of pixels here shown with a little bitmap. Now, this is done. If we go into the list view and have a look at the events, there's an on update objects. And in there, it does a little calculation of the height. So we can see it's getting the text main, which is the drawable item with a variable text height, and we're getting the contents of that, and then we're doing funny things with the font size and what have you. But this method here calculates the height, and so if I just control click on that, we'll see it creates a layout and then fills it with the same font and what have you, and puts the text in, and we get the thing at the height of the layout. And then we add, I think, by the look of things, it adds one additional line. So what we'll do is we'll create a new project, and we want a multi-device application, and blank. And to that, we'll obviously need a list view. I'll call it LV fish because we're going to do fish facts. And let's just align to client. We are, of course, going to want to have some data. So we'll add a client data set. And we'll call it CDS fish. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go back to the welcome page and go open sample project and copy this path, because I'm going to want to go into the data folder, load my base table, paste that in. Let's have a look at data, and biolife is our fish facts. So that's our data loaded. So I'm just going to right click and go into the fields editor and add all fields. And let's save this project off. See, I've got a fish facts already. Nope. Excellent. So next, we want to go into the item appearance and change this to dynamic and toggle design time mode. There's our item text. Let's align that leading and make it a bit smaller. Not quite that small. That's good. Okay, and we'll need a bit more space. Well, okay, let's assign that to 80. And we'll have the, let's throw on another text. So let's call this one, to name it, we need to go into text one and change the appearance object name to txt common name. Add a new text item. And endeavor to resize it. I find this editor to be very awkward, and I never really know if I'm doing something wrong or it's just me or the editor's buggy. Let's align that to leading as well. Oops. Text align leading. And we'll add 1/3 text object and text align is leading and leading, and we'll resize it down to below like so. We'll call this, I have to go back to here. Species name and text 3. Description. And we'll finally add a image. Which we want to make nice and small. Throw in this tiny gap here. Okay. And we want to call that one cool, IMG fish. Okay, let's go back to our main view and save all that. Oh, except we don't save project one, but that's cool. But our fish facts are saved. Let's now see if we can get these live bindings correct. So we'll bind visually. Let's get a little bit of separation between those two. Now, let's sync those together. We've got a bunch of things. So our graphic goes to IMG fish. And we have our fish, common name to common name, species name to species name, and notes to description. Like so. And we'll see that our notes aren't quite working. Don't think we need the live binding designer anymore, but we can run this and have a look and see what it's doing. So basically our text looks like it's not wrapping, so we'll need to sort that out. And we want to make the list view item and the text to expand to fill the available space or take up. Anyway. Oops, don't edit mode, we want toggle design mode. So let's turn word wrap on that. And also, let's make that one bold and that one italic. So we get a little bit of differentiation between the various items. And hopefully that will look a little bit better. Indeed. Okay. We basically now just want to steal some code from this project, and it's the get text height, so that's conveniently there. So I'm just going to copy that and paste it in. Control-Shift-C. We need a text layout, which we find in, what do you know, FMX text layout. I might actually put that at the top. And that gets rid of all of our errors. And of course, we are going to need an event on update objects from which, let's just take all this and copy it and paste it. So we don't care about our bitmap stuff. So I'm just going to remove all that. And so the available width is basically all the available width. We get our text from text description. And we don't care about this randomizing the size at all, so we can delete all that. And so I am going to create another variable called text height. And am I in insert mode? I am too. So let's just get our text height from here. And the item height is also going to be, well, so we need to add to that our drawable, draw TList item, placement offset, I was looking for position. Why? So take the where it's located. So let's run. Will this run? I might have gotten this right. Let's run it and find out. Integer and extended. Yes. My overwriting. Is that a single? Yes. And there's an integer as well. So let's call round. Okay, and now it's changing the height of the text. Now, you might think this is actually getting this wrong. And I did have to do quite a bit of debugging on this to try and work out what was going on, but let's just throw a trim around that. And there we have our variable height text. There's our fish image, common name, species name, and text, and probably want to juggle things around a little bit, make things a little bit tighter and what have you, but I think this serves as a pretty good example of this working. And I can save that off. Now, there is an issue with this, which I will show you shortly. So let's close all that. No, we don't need to see if it changes the project grip. And if we open this project and run it under Windows, yep. What it does is not overly important, but it does do a, it's got a logging window. Let's turn debug mode on to add some test lines. And so this is the log. It's got a title and some text. And we'll see it's got two lines there. But if I click add lines and add a new one, it's actually four lines. But when I add a new record, the this is the default size. So it's initially the default size, and then we add some text. I suspect it's something to the live bindings. And if we go to Stack Overflow, and here it is, here's my question on it. It's had 32 views and no solution. So basically, for some reason, with the live bindings in place, it's not getting the initial, back to Delphi. It's getting the initial size, and then when I add a new one, it's then getting the recalculating the size based on the text correctly. And so that's something I need to sort out. It's not necessarily a particularly major issue, but if you have a solution, post it in the comments or answer the Stack Overflow question, and I'll give you a nice green tick. That's all I have time for. Reminder, my free content and premium videos, get the mega pack, it's good. It's mostly VCL stuff. And if you've got like a new developer coming on board your team or something like that, it's a great way of getting them up to speed on the VCL. And there's generic collections and some other bits and pieces in there as well. But the mega pack is certainly the best value. Thanks for watching. I'm Alister Christie.